Click the link down in the comments or in the description to get your free Motion Offense ebook.
Do you have a call right away to make? So what we have is we have audibles and we have formations. Okay, the audibles we'll go with first. And the audibles are very simple. These are all Krzyzewski audibles now. Okay, stuff that I saw him do when my son played in college. And the first thing when we come down, okay, when you come down the court, if you call shallow, okay, when you call shallow, you're going to replace the wing. You're going to replace each other. So if we came down the court now, right, and we got to this formation, okay, we got to this formation, and you had the ball here on the wing. Okay, you had the ball up top, okay? And we kind of wound. You had curled, right? You would come out and curl. And your post, and no, you're not. So you went right to a fade. And we kind of played four around one right now because that was the personnel. I think you're more comfortable away from the basket right now. And you're probably more comfortable away from the basket too, right? So this is how we happen to be in this formation right now because you were the first big down the court, so we'll look to post you. But we come down now, and we happen to have you here, and we say shallow. So we say shallow now, you're just going to circle right around the post guy and come right back up to the top of the circle. I'm going to bring right back to, you're going to replace me. And I'm going to bring the ball down off my dribble, okay, and we've replaced each other. This gives me a chance now to take a look at the post, all right? And now from that move, we change the look. The big thing with motion is you can change the entire motion by where the ball goes to. It changes the entire look. That gives you a chance now. So first move is you call shallow and players exchange positions. Now, when we hear shallow, that allows the post player, and say the ball happened to be here right now. Shallow, call shallow out. That gives him a chance. Now you can turn absolutely now, and you can come out and screen him. And now he can go. They're not switching that because it's big, small. So you know that in that screening situation, we get a chance to roll him. And then on the other side, because it's motion, there is spacing and there is time. You don't get yourself in a position where you make a cut to the side of the floor that's occupied by two players or more right now. So if they happen to have what they have right now, which is a triangle, we're not looking to bring one of these two players to this side of the court. If it was a two-man situation and you had made that pass and you had made a hard cut through, then spacing purposes now, that would allow you to slide in motion, and we still had an opportunity here to play off that first move, which is just saying shallow. When we call circle, okay, and the ball is up top, when we call circle, we're sending this player to the opposite side of the court. You want to get him a jump shot. You run a circle for him. Okay, you send him to the other side of the court. So we come down and we call circle. So you're chasing him and you bring it down off the dribble. Replace. Now hold your position right there. When we throw this pass right now, okay, it's a circle. You can now back screen him and send him, or you can set a screen for him right now, okay, and he'll come off that screen looking for a jump shot right now off the circle move, okay, or you can just chase him and then everybody adjusts on the floor. But circle means I'm sending the player away from the ball. When we have circle, we read right now. You know, you get a perimeter player, a big kid who wound up trailing the play. Here's a great situation on circle. You send a shooter through, a bigger kid's out on the perimeter. On circle now, there's the ball. I set a screen for him right now. Big goes to the basket, and we do this a lot. Got to rub off me, though. We got to go shoulder to shoulder so they can't get through. So you come right off me. I gave you that screen. I step right to the ball. He looks for the lob. He turns it right into a button hook. You see that happening. You flash right to the high post. And because we saw we're going after something, we go after a particular thing. So circle gives you some options to reverse the ball. When your team is stagnant, a circle means we're going to bring it all the way around to the other side of the court and look to get something. Okay, cross. When we run a cross, we're down the court now, and we cross the wings to start. But we could come down, and we're a little stagnant. So we say we come down the court right now, okay, and we've got the ball here, and we call a cross. What we'll do now is we'll just cross our wings. So we're down here in half-court offense already. You can now, he crosses, and you'll screen in the lane. Okay, you know it's coming this way now, so now you can wind up setting what amounts to a stagger. Okay, so now you come right off the second screen. That ducks you right in under the basket for a pin now. All right, so when you hear a cross, you know it's an opportunity to cross the wings and perhaps use the post guy to turn it into a stagger. Okay, and it becomes, all of these become quick hitters for you. Okay, from cross, we call a hold. Okay, so if we're down the court and we call a hold, all right, when we say hold, and we'll say hold for first name. Nathan. So we got a hole for Nathan. That means we'll take the two players on the weak side of the floor, and we're going to set a double. So when we call the hold, whether it's out of an open formation or what I'm going to show you, the stacks, we're going to get into this. So if we call a hold, let's come down here and form a double right now. Okay? And we go shoulder to shoulder on a double. Okay? Or we can do this. We started doing this year. We started putting guys like this. We keep them separate, and we would run the guy on hold. Now, you can back screen him, or you can occupy the defense by trying to come in here and receive the ball, but we called it for you, so you can start running through, and now you get to here, and now you're going to run right through the middle of it, close the door, and now bottom guy is always going to go opposite, and now you're going to pin him. Okay, so they run a shooter through on a hold. Okay, they run a shooter through on hold now, and then they take the shooter of the two, and they run him off this screen now. Okay, and now from there, they post this guy right into a duck in. I can remember seeing this play against Georgia Tech when my son was in college. And what Mike Krzyzewski is great at taking a kid who has a particular talent. You know that a lot of times your best post-up guy is not your biggest kid. There's a kid on your team who's 6'2 or a strong guard, and you get him in the post. So what Duke used to do is use Thomas Hill, a teammate of Bobby's. He would be the post guy. So what they did was, in one game, to win a game, they ran a hold for a guy, okay? Now they ran the hold to this side. So we say to Tui, we had the Tui form a double over here, okay? They took the guy that they wanted to post, and he was here on this side of the court. They ran that guy around, okay? And now from this side of the court, they brought a shooter around this side. They came running around, okay? And now, as they brought him out, they ducked him right in front of the rim. They were worried about guard. If they threw it in here, he's left-handed. He took a dribble and made a left-handed layup with about 2 seconds left on the clock, because they went after a specific player. They went to his best move, and they put him in a spot where he could make the shot. So in like watching a team, when you know you have a certain talent that you know that we talked about, I think we were talking about this last night, how bad perimeter players are post-defense. So if you have a kid who's pretty good around the basket, that's something in motion offense you can use coming off a, you know, off a stack or something. You put him in there where you can run it. Now the hold, okay.